Hi everyone, and let's pick up where we left off in the last video. What I've added to our spreadsheet from the last video is a few extra columns here. We now have a shipping discount column and a grand total column, as well as a shipping discount table up here. One thing that we haven't filled in from our last video is the total shipping price. As you can guess, it's simply the quantity times the unit shipping price that we calculated in the previous video. In this video, we want to introduce something called the horizontal lookup function. Sometimes our values in our lookup tables are distributed across our columns as opposed to in rows like we had in our last video. In this case, we have a table with horizontal values. We have a total price up here in the first row, and then these shipping discounts here on the second and third rows that correspond to the total price. So to discover the shipping discount, we use the HLOOKUP function. HLOOKUP compares a value to the first row of the data in our lookup table as opposed to how the VLOOKUP function compared a value to its first column of data. Also similar to the VLOOKUP function, the first row, or in this case the total price values, have to be in ascending order, but now it's ascending from left to right as opposed to top to bottom. It's going to compare a value that we want to look up against the first value of our top row. And if that lookup value is greater than that value, it then compares the lookup value to the next value in the row and continues on down that row until it comes up to a value that it is less than. Excel then goes back to the previous value that passed its last test and retrieves whatever row that you asked for in the row number property. So let's start our HLOOKUP function here. Equals HLOOKUP looks for a value in the top row of a table or array of values and returns the value in the same column from a row you specify. Yeah, that's kind of what I said before. We see our first parameter of this formula is again the lookup value, and we're going to look up the total price here in cell F14. Next, we need to reference the table array, so I'll highlight all of this data cells from our lookup table up here. Remember that when we select the range of our table array, that we don't include our header rows or columns. The next parameter is the row index number. The row index number is the number of the row from which we want to grab the discount from. We have two options here, shipping discount 1 and shipping discount 2. For this video, in this scenario, we're going to choose shipping discount 2. That will be the third row in this table, so I'll type 3 in here, and then we hit true or false depending on whether we want an approximate match or an exact match like we previously worked through in our VLOOKUP function. Because we probably won't have all the exact matches here in the total price column, i.e. not all of our lookup values are going to be only 0, 300, or 1,000, we're going to use true for the approximate match. So what this formula will now do is to take the value in cell F14, compare it to 0. If it's above 0, and it is, then we'll compare it to 300. Since it's above 300, then we'll go to 1,000. Since it's below 1,000, Excel will drop down to the previous value and return the third row discount, which is 10%. If this was greater than or equal to 1,000, it would return 15%, but since we are well below that, we just go back and render our 10%. This now gives us the shipping discount percentage. Now discounts are usually taken off of the total, so this is going to have to be a negative value. We can make this a negative value by just putting a negative sign at the front of our HLOOKUP function. In this case, it'll be a negative 10% if my calculations are correct. We don't want to have a negative 10% here for the shipping discount, so it looks like our HLOOKUP function by itself is not quite enough. We want this cell to apply the discount percentage, this 10%, to the total shipping cost of $48 here in column H. Let's take the discount of negative 10% and apply it to cell H14 by multiplying them together. This gives us a value of negative $4.80 for our shipping discount. It's negative because it needs to be a discount, and I like this formatting here because it jumps out at me that this is now a negative value as opposed to all of these positive ones here in the same table. We can subtract it to get a grand total here in a second, but we first need to fix these cell references for our lookup table. So click here in our formula and hit F4 here and click here and hit F4 again to lock those cell references in place. Now that those are fixed, I can drag the formula down and we're done with the shipping discount column. There are some dashes in these cells, so we have some zero values, so they must not meet the minimum total price of $300 in order to receive a discount. Let's test out all of this logic by copying this row down one more to create a test order. I'll edit the quantity to an even 100 units and the shipping type to something other than customer so that there are actually some shipping charges, and I can easily do the math, hopefully still in my head. Now I'll override the math here in this total price column to $299, keeping in mind that our threshold here is $300. Okay, a shipping discount of zero. Now I'll change it to $300, and I should get a shipping discount of $2. So that math checks out. That's good. Now let's check out the last barrier here in my HLOOKUP of 1,000. Put in $999, still $2. 1,000, and we get the next higher discount rate of 15%, so that all checks out. Now to finish up this table and calculate the grand total, it's simply going to be required to add our price amounts together here in column J. Equals, sum, now the total price, the total shipping, and our newly created shipping discount. Please notice that we simplified our formula here by taking advantage of the fact that the discount is a negative amount, and that allows us to use the sum formula and just include these three cells here on our sum function. If this cell wasn't negative, it would look something like this. Let me take the negative sign out. And we would have to build the formula by, instead of this, by adding the total price, the total shipping, and then subtracting the shipping discount in order to get the right answer. Both ways you get the same output number and therefore the right answer. But let me undo this to go back to our previous better way. This way is more visually intuitive, and that's always a good idea. I'll copy this sum function down and delete our test row, and that completes this table. So this is a customized order form for tennis balls. In the next level, we'll create order forms for all of our tennis products.